Hello, Guilty Gear fans. This is Shadow Fury 333 with what is now kind of a typical weekly Guilty Gear training diary thing. And without further ado, let's begin. Go for ranked match. See if anyone's playing ranked match. You never know. Sometimes people are. Sometimes. Not always. Possibly not now. But sometimes. And apparently there are people, so or at least person. There are person playing. One whole person. Hooray! We have a game. Okay, so I will continue to play Millia as I always do, because I like Millia. And where gets a soul? Have I played a soul on stream? I don't think I have. Soul is a very tricky character to play against because souls tend to be aggressive. We'll see what this one's like. Soul players do tend to be aggressive in my experience, so we'll find out. Make you respect my pin! Nope, that's not respecting my pin. And mind you, that wasn't also making you respect my pin, so fair enough. Ah! I'd like my pin back, please. Come on. Ah. Well, that doesn't work. Like I said about aggression, that's... Okay. Approaching from the air is apparently a bad idea. At least pushing from the air trying to dust for whatever reason. And this is where I have to... So, Dragon Install, for those of you not familiar, is essentially Soul becoming super powerful and killing me. Well, okay, Soul becomes much more powerful for a brief period and then has to cool down afterwards, which is a problem because that brief period is often long enough to get a win. Although, admittedly, I'm not sure how strong it's considered as a move in general. There we go. Are you gonna... I thought they're gonna burst. Come on. Oh, darn it. Nope. Good Roman cancel. Man, they're doing a really good job keeping their spacing. I can't seem to throw them easily. Although, okay, I'm getting hit. I say that as I'm getting hit. Actually, I say that as I'm about to get it. Oh, come on. Seriously? That was close enough for me to get a throw off. Wow. I could have thrown off of that when they were just about to dust me. Well, bit of an ignominious start, but let's continue. Because, well, that was a start. Can only go up from there, right? Well, okay, assuming I can find people. But yeah, souls tend to be rather aggressive, as you noticed there. Because they have a lot of stuff that's plus on block, and so they don't often have to respect players, especially when they're playing Millia, and Millia is essentially a character that can't really do much until she does everything. Like, if she hits in a good position, then it's really hard to get out of that. Otherwise, let's try that. What happens if I entry? Will anyone join? I actually didn't notice this feature before, the entry feature. I feel kind of embarrassed about that, because when I was talking last week about how I wish there was a way you could just say, I want to play, this is halfway there. It's not the entire thing, because I don't think you can have two people hitting entry and then as a result get a match. If you can, that's great, and this would be a better way of doing it than the search, but as far as I know, basically it's people search and then other people entry, and that's... I don't understand that. I really don't understand the logic of that, because that means that you have to have everyone kind of knowing that there's enough people entering in order to search for them, but I don't know if that's how that works. If I can get entry and then match with another person using entry, perfect. Search is kind of redundant, but yes. Begin match. But yeah, if that's the case, that makes search redundant, but whatever. I mean, it's not great from a quality of life perspective, but if search is redundant, then you just don't use search. There you go. Wow, 13 consecutive wins. Well, they are a fairly strong player. Probably a console player from before. Of course, yeah, here it's going to turn out that it's someone I know from locals. I mean, if it is someone I know from locals, I know exactly who it would be, but this is kind of embarrassing. I don't think it's them. They also wouldn't be watching this, so they wouldn't know. There we go. Nope. Ah, yes, got a hit in. Oops, I wanted to disc, not to get hit. What? Ah, shoot. I still had tension, too. Actually, I don't know if it is. The person I'm thinking of doesn't dragon install anywhere near as much as this player does, so I don't think they're the same. I mean, they're equally aggressive, but they don't tend to dragon install much. And that was a command throw. Soul's trying to command throw me, and that didn't work. Ah, I almost got a free throw. Again, and again the free throw opportunities. Oops. Wait, will that hit? Nope. Oh, that was so close to hitting. There we go. Oh, that was a perfect time for... You have to do a trick called faultless defense break, that's what it's called. Which is when you... If you do the faultless defense move, that, you end up breaking immediately. So you can actually do tricks where you... Well, not so much a trick, but basically you can't throw while moving. Well, while dashing. But you can do that. Oh yeah, that worked! That didn't work. That was supposed to be a disc. Aw, oh, they woke up in time? Wow, this is way too close. What?! That must be a new move, because I don't remember that... I don't remember seeing that before. I'm confused now. Gotta look that up. So close, too. But is that a new move, that smash into the ground thing? Because that... Could be a new move from Exert. I don't remember that from Accent Core. And I haven't really seen it in Exert much either, so it's actually kind of weird. I want to go into training mode right now and just see what Sol has, because I feel like I missed something. I feel pretty strongly like I missed something, actually. I'm a little concerned. However, I am glad to know the entry thing works fairly well, so that's cool. So yeah, let me think. That player... So, quite aggressive, but... I don't think they necessarily respect the pin enough. If I could counter hit off that could be nice. Then again, I haven't given them much reason to respect the pin, so that would probably not help. I'm kind of surprised how often they try to go for the command throw, though. I mean, when I'm out of range, go for the command throw. Alright, let's try this again. Same player! Let's see if I can use what I've learned from playing them so far. I gotta keep my distance, primarily. That seems to be the key thing. As long as I keep my distance fairly well, it should be fine. I haven't figured out how good they are at spacing, though. That's one thing I'm curious about. Why are they waiting to respond? I'm not sure how many other opponents you're going to find here. I'm not sure if they're waiting for another opponent or what. It's me again! I hope you like me! I guess they don't. I don't like this. Why are they taking forever to respond? Like, I want to play them again. I really do. I feel like I have a lot to learn as far as the Sol matchup goes, especially... since that seems like I'm fairly close in skill to this person. Like, that last match was fairly close, and without warming up, I was already doing okay. So I feel like I actually do have a decent chance. It's just actually getting that game going. But yeah, I do notice that they actually were doing a lot of risky things where they were running up really close to me. Like, there were a couple opportunities where I had to actually throw them out of a super or throw them out of a... Well, the Dragon Install super thing or Dragon Install Dust that happened in the first couple of matches. Like, I could have thrown, I think, in both of those cases. Okay, cool. Are you going to respond this time? Or is it the game screwing up? I hope not. I hope the game isn't screwing up, because that would be terrible. Come on, I want to play you. Well, I hope this is riveting television for people who are watching. I mean, I don't know what's going on here. Like, this really doesn't make sense to me. Maybe I have to cancel entry and try again? See if I can find them in search. Let's see, finding them in search would possibly work. I don't like canceling, no. It seemed like the entry system was so perfect. Ah. Can we connect? Can we play? Come on, let's go. I mean, hey, if ranked match is going to let me choose my opponents, I might as well go for sets. Seems like a solid idea. It's generally what's recommended when it comes to fighting games is playing sets, because that allows you to learn an opponent and also allows you to learn how to play over a long period of time. Because in a tournament, you're playing 3 to 5 if you're evenly matched games. Well, actually, 2 to 5 games. And that's important. It's important to be able to understand how to learn an opponent within 2 or 3 matches. Well, ideally within 1 match, but yeah. Like, knowing how to play over the course of several matches with the same person, like they're learning from you and you're learning from them, and trying to deal with that, that's really important in a tournament environment. That's vital in a tournament environment. I really wish that music would loop properly. Total tangent, but I really wish that music would loop properly. It actually doesn't loop properly. It misses. I don't know why it does that, but it's like halfway through, it just suddenly... Anyway. Beside the point, looks like I cannot connect to this person, which really bums me out, because I was enjoying playing them. A lot. Really enjoying playing them. Well, let's try this again. I just find this very strange, because clearly they wanted to play me. Actually, what am I saying? If it's entry and search, they have to work together. That means that Audio 33 wants to play against me, because they would have searched, seen my name, gone, oh yeah, I've been playing them, and selected me to play against. I'm pretty sure they want to play against me. Okay, well. Not the same person, but somebody. Damn. I really was enjoying playing against that. I really want to play against that guy more. I probably should, or person more. Probably should add him as a friend on Steam. Just to be able to play them more. Alright, Ramlethal player. So for all you who like brawlers or spectacle fighters, Ramlethal is your character. That's basically how she works, as we may see, assuming I actually get attacked. Yeah, like, moves like that are... Oops. Not that, that's a throw. But things like that, those are just punch and kick. But they're combination attacks as you get in a brawler or a spectacle fighter. Actually, more so a spectacle fighter. Can't necessarily speak to brawlers, or I should say beat-em-ups, but definitely Spectacle Fighter. What the? Come on, there we go! Ah! Oops. Ow! How did I survive that? Well, shoot. Really don't know how that happened, but yeah, so that's how she works. It's actually kind of tricky to chain those together, though, because she only has, like... If you used to play, like, Devil May Cry or Bayonet or something like that, where you have several moves, like, 3 to 5 moves in a given given string, and then you just combo them together with the, like, you have a few seconds and your combo meter still counts. Yeah, you don't get that so much here, but from what I've seen from other Ramlethal players, basically what you do is... Why'd I do that? That was really risky. Anyway, from what I've seen from Ramlethal players, the key thing to do is not to complete any of Ramlethal's chains. Well, let's do the silly thing. That, I expected to drop down. Ah, you have no... And I have no air dash, apparently. There we go. That super is really risky. I'm actually kind of surprised this player is doing this often. The beam super like that? I mean, the explode super I would probably go with more, or... Actually, no, I wouldn't go with the explode super. The explode super when blocked is not very strong, but if you know your opponent's not going to block, like, it's actually really surprisingly annoying to deal with. Because you can't hit through it. It's fully invincible, as far as I know. I'm pretty sure it's fully invincible on the way, and I have to double-check that. Because Japanese games don't like to have hitboxes shown, although admittedly, there's actually a hitbox viewer, which is great for however long that lasts before it gets cease and desisted by Arxis. Ah, come on. Oops. Not what I wanted. What I wanted. What? I don't even know what was going on there. I was thinking too hard about the hitbox stuff. Because I'm trying to think. Because I think her explode super is invincible as she's approaching. Like, you can't hit her out of it. But you can block it. So it's actually a really good super to use. Or at least it seems like a fairly good super to use. I mean, Guilty Gear in general is not a game where you use supers all that often. But compared to just using the meter for Roman cancels and other similar tricks. Roman cancels, and occasionally, though more so in Revelator, what's it called? The Blitz Shield, that's it, Blitz Shield, yeah, use it for that. But for supers, not necessarily so much. I think the other super using, for Ramlethal using her two little demon minions, I think the one that the blades that spin around, she can actually act while that's happening. So she isn't locked in place like she is with the beam. Like, the beam is all or nothing. Either deals a ton of damage, your opponent gets behind you and then just hits you. And just gets a free combo. Okay, this isn't working. I don't know why they're not able to join or play. But for whatever reason, they can't. And that's terrible. I mean, really, that genuinely annoys me. Let's try you, who is apparently at 0 bars. How is this gonna work? Ooh, okay, I have not shown Elphelt yet, I don't think. Who is actually another character I was sort of considering playing. Because I like gunslinging characters in fighting games, but she's kind of an exception. I don't know why, but yeah. I think I just sort of heard stuff about her that wasn't great, and also it's like everyone... Well, okay, I shouldn't say everyone plays Elphelt, because everyone plays Millia, and that doesn't stop me so far. Admittedly, the voice being annoying might be a part of it. And that's actually true in either Japanese or English. It's not just an English dub thing. Although... Ugh. I was actually kind of surprised when I looked up who the voice actor was for this. I mean, anyone who's watched my channel knows that I'm a bit of a Madoka fan. And a bit, I mean that. Like, not a huge one. But Elphelt's Kyubei. At least the English dub version of Kyubei. Yeah, I was kind of surprised about that. It's more obvious when you listen to it during the story mode stuff. Oops. Whoa, that was risky. I mean, I got hit for different reasons, but that was... I kind of surprised I didn't get hit doing that. Oops. I don't know why I'm trying to use crouching heavy slash as an anti-air. Like, that's not an anti-air, that's a launcher. Forward punch, on the other hand, yes, that is an anti-air, but I'm not doing that. Ah, come on. Oops. This is not working out the way I'd like to. Whoa, what the heck? Crossed on my dust. Hey, I've got no burst! Okay, but why doesn't that work? I keep messing up my... Like, I don't know what it is, but I keep messing up my ball follow-ups. I'm supposed to go down forward. Down back, not straight forward. Why does it not consider it? Little things like that keep messing me up. On a side note, I kind of hope that Jam's voice isn't annoying in English, but I know that's a vain hope. Bearing in mind that Jam is my other character, like, back from Accent Core. Jam is actually the character I played the most. I moved to Millia a bit later on, but Jam is the character I started with. And her voice was annoying as... It was annoying as, like, a chihuahua's scratching on a blackboard in the middle of a bird preserve. Something like that. It's not a particularly pleasant voice to listen to. And the current Revelator voice actor in Japanese is basically about... It's not the same voice actor as before, but it's about the same vocal quality. Like, they're going for the same thing. Because they're going for the super high-pitched Chinese stereotype. I don't know. I don't really know Japanese stereotypes of Chinese people very well. But apparently that's what Jam is. So, yeah, there you go. Not sure that the high-pitched voice is necessarily a Chinese stereotype. I think it's more of a Bruce Lee thing that she's trying, that they're trying to go for, like the high-pitched Kiai thing that Bruce Lee used to do. Well, I mean, you know, when he's alive. But yeah, I don't know. I mean, it seems likely, even though there's sort of a kung fu theme to her, sort of, kind of, I guess. But yeah, it doesn't really. Doesn't really work for me, you know? Okay, let's see if I can make this work. Well, that was... Not a terrible start. They didn't manage to punish off that, but... Man, I'm getting reluctant to use the ball just before how often it's failed on me. Oops. There we go! Down! Well, oh, come on! Well, I said it was an unsafe combo, but occasionally it works. Or not combo, unsafe special, but okay, or super. Overdrive, whatever it's called. That was an unsafe hellburst. I got too close. That was my bad. I was trying to forward kick. I don't know how to do a forward kick combo without being right in the corner. That's the combo thing. Actually, wait, that's not my combo. What am I saying? I should have teched out of that twice. That is sort of the right idea, though, that they were doing, where it's like two moves of a chain. That was close enough to throw? How much throw range does this character have? Oh, of course, I had to knock him out of my throw. Or out of my, not throw, my follow-up. Seriously? Man, this is annoying. I'd like to win once. Sheesh. Really? I lost. That doesn't make any sense. They must have some sort of provisional rank thing going on where your rank is actually like 10 or something. And it's just the number of matches you play increases your rank up to that point, and then they actually care about win-loss ratio. Okay, can I finally play Audio 33 again? I actually enjoyed playing them. I guess, yeah, part of it is that I actually, like I said, there's a soul in my local group, so it's actually worth my time to practice the soul matchup more than it's worth practice the Ramlethal matchup. Not to mention, Ramlethal's considered bottom tier in Excerpt 1.1, in Sign 1.1. So I don't know. I mean, I don't hate her as a character, it's just, she's not the most useful character to practice against. Okay, why is it not connecting? Whatever. Yeah, Ramlethal's got a weird range to her that's very difficult to get in on. But I guess I'm playing the Ramlethal player. I don't know what's going on in this game sometimes. I guess someone else must have jumped into that match. Let's try you again. I really wish I knew why I couldn't connect to Audio 33, because that's bugging me. A new assassin. There's no turning back now. All right, let's try this one again. That's where I gotta throw the disc down. It's just hard to justify doing that when... Oh, whoops, that was actually a really good setup. Oops. Shoot, nope. Well, that didn't quite work. Oh, actually, that was a really bad idea. And it's a really bad idea because now... Now I'm fine. For a second there, I actually didn't have enough tension to do any of my proper setups safely. There we go. I really like Dust. In case you haven't noticed, I really like Dust. I probably rely on Dust way too much, but I really like Dust because it does a good job since people tend to block low, since that's what you're supposed to do. But Millia's Dust has a weird animation to it since it matches her role, sort of. And it's thus kind of easy to confuse an opponent who's expecting a roll to use instead the Dust. Especially since they're going, oh, you're doing something, I'll block low. Since you're on the ground, I'm assuming you're going to go low. And like I said, I don't know how to follow up her kick, her forward kick, which isn't standing overhead. And she doesn't have the same power off of her bad moon as she used to. Which used to be kind of her go-to. Darn it. There we go. I think that I'm too... Oh, wow, that actually worked. Oh, crap. That may not be as bad as I thought it was. That's actually faster than I thought it was. Ah, shoot. Okay, I think they're learning how to deal with my dusts. And I'm not learning how to... Why didn't that work? That's not something you want to do in neutral, but I... Whoops. Oh, that actually worked. Almost. And by almost, I mean it actually very nearly failed on me. Yeah, I figured I could get away with that. Not that. There we go. I think I got this. Let's see. Do I have it? What? I didn't have that? Oh, I did! Yes! Thank you, ball! I'm surprised that ball actually works as well as it did, seeing as the balls had been unreliable up to this point. But yeah! I was on the ball! Well, the ball was certainly on the ball. Because Zero was thinking, oh crap, I should probably have Roman cancelled that, or otherwise gotten out of the way. Because I think that move would have actually killed me had the Secret Garden not hit Ramlethal halfway through it. Hooray, I win! Alright. And only 45 minutes in. Well, actually, half an hour in. Seriously? They probably got someone else joining them. That's fine. Why is the match always cancelled? I don't understand that. Why would they cancel it? If they're waiting for somebody, you join a lobby, you invite a friend, and you work from there. I don't see why you're canceling the entry. Or canceling whatever. Like I said, I don't know how this works. I don't know if multiple people join up and you have to pick, because it seems like from the entry position, only one person joins. That the first person who joins basically gets priority. But I don't know. Because this is not a very transparent system, and there's a bunch of stuff going on. It's one of those systems where there's a lot of information about what goes on, but not enough to really understand it. So there's enough for me to know that there's something going on as far as players manually selecting other players to play against. Oh, they're rank 8 now? But at the same time... Oh, I see. They're a Mei player that was just... Okay, so they have a pocket Ramlethal, but they're playing Mei. Not sure if I've shown a Mei before. Mei is a very zoning-oriented character. Actually, Mei is a flexible character. That's kind of the weird thing. She can be zoning-oriented. This one might not be. I don't know. As soon as she starts throwing dolphins, then we'll know. Oh, come on. Whoa, that was actually a combo? I want my pin back. There- oh, no, I guess- okay, so they play an aggressive Mei from the looks of it. I kind of wish I played her music in this case, like, I don't know why she's not considered player one here. I really like Mei's song in this- well, I like Mei's music in general in Guilty Gear, but especially like in- actually, yeah, especially like in an excerpt. It's probably my favorite song off the excerpt soundtrack. And we're listening to Millia's, which is a good song, but not my favorite. Ah. Oh, shoot. Oh no, it's the whale! Whale! I will call that every single time the whale happens. It's a bit of a thing that my friends and I used to do, but yeah. Every time Mei summons the whale, you have to yell, whale. Because that's how it works. Because that whale... Whoa, what? Their framer just start tanking or something? I'm pretty sure mine's fine. This is really strange. Yeah, my frame rate's fine. I mean, you can kind of tell from watching it that it's fine. Well, actually, you can't easily tell, but I have a frame rate counter independently that... It's fine. Oh. Shoot. Darn, I was doing so well the first game. What the hell? I mean, yeah, I lost at the end, but that was a close match. Okay, they don't have enough meter to wail, but... This is like playing in molasses! What the heck happened to their connection? And in case you're wondering about the stream stuff, this uses less than a third of my internet capacity. Oh, they just want it done. Fair. Where are... What the heck? Storm my inputs. I think this is it. Or almost. Wow, seriously? Yeah, that was just about it. Ah, chip damage! Yeah, because they don't have any tension, because they're in instant kill mode. This game's gotta go on for even longer. I apologize, Puppini, but yeah. I'm not gonna just throw the match just because it's inconvenient. Oh. Hey, it worked! Oops. Way too close. Okay, they're in a connections. It's back to normal. Well! Ah! Worst time to crouch ever! Right in the middle of their dust startup. I was blocking a high right as their dust startup started. Worst time to crouch. I was blocking perfectly. Wow. So close. So close to getting that. Actually, I think I might have had the meter to do the disc suit. No, I didn't have. I had about 30% meter. I didn't have quite enough. Yeah, because I was doing the ball and I didn't RC it. Which I probably should get in the habit of doing, just in general. Like, if I have to follow up with Secret Garden, I should probably follow up with Secret Garden by actually Roman canceling it, since it doesn't seem as safe as the disc. It takes a lot longer to start up. Was someone trying to join me? I wouldn't mind playing that Mei again. Especially since I know that that's their main character. Or at least their higher ranked character. So presumably their main. Although I felt like the Ramlethal was scarier, but then again, I just don't know Ramlethal that well. So hopefully their internet doesn't go out. I hope they're not on wireless. That's actually something that I didn't consider, but they may be on wireless, which would be a problem. That explains their title, actually. Cute Justice makes a lot more sense for Mei. There we go! I got Mei's theme and Millia's stage. Okay, but hey, it's Mei's music. The music I said was my favorite music in the Exert soundtrack, and I stand by that. This is some great music. That was a really bad time to burst for them, but whatever. Especially since now I can do that. Remember I mentioned getting in the habit of doing that? Oh, come on. I screwed up the air dash. Well, at least, okay. I pinned. That was the important thing, I think. Is that unsafe? Do I actually have an... Oh. Okay. Well, got my pin back at least. Oops. Not what I wanted at all. Does she have a longer dust? I think she's a longer sweep range than I do. Darn it. That's annoying. Oh yeah, I know what I'm supposed to do against aggressive players. Do the light tandem top. Actually, that and block. That I figured would... Actually, I was surprised the burst would happen. That's an odd place to burst, but I guess it works okay. I mean, actually, not an odd place to burst. What am I saying? That's actually a really good place to burst. Because the problem for them is that I'm in that situation and I'm going to be... Come on. Ooh, nice try in the forward kick. Ah. Successful. Nice try on that. Oh, wait, that's not going to work at all. Ah, I guess I am serious. Oh, come on. Seriously? I feel like there were so many missed opportunities in that match. Oh, wait, I'm already in the match. I just have to wait! This is slightly better user experience than what I've been experiencing thus far. Hmm. Really? Top players online are all Ramlethal? That's not what I expected, but okay. I guess Ramlethal isn't as bad as I thought. That, or it's just something to do with the way online play works. I don't know. Like, the character I play, Millia, is a top-tier character, but she's being played by a person who doesn't know the game super well. So it might skew it the wrong way. Tier lists are for high-level play. And as any Air-Dash player knows, high-level play and online play don't often mix. Not for games without GGPO or similar rollback netcode. But we discussed that last time, how netcode works. Are people not joining? Oh! Alright, let's try this one more time. Be the last one. Last one for tonight. Let's just try this, see what happens. Oh, what?! Seriously? What, are they sick of playing against me or something? Thought I offered at least something of a challenge. I feel like I wonder, is it that they're refusing, or is it just that... No, they can't be, because they would have... Or would they? No, because they would have been choosing me, right? I don't know how this works. I really am annoyed that I don't know how this works, but I don't. I'm also annoyed that I'm hanging out in the ranked match window for minutes at a time. What am I supposed to talk about? Like, oh yeah, I've got to roam and cancel my secret gardens when it's unsafe. I've got to get my... I don't know why my air dash isn't working especially well today, but, you know, got to make sure that that's always, always, always working, because then that way I can actually, you know, follow up as I need to do. There we go! Okay, so it's just the game messing things up. Alright, last one against May. Let's see if I can do this. Oh, come on. Please wait, really? It takes that long to synchronize. Okay, next match that actually happens will be the last match. I don't want to end off on nothing. I would like to play Puppini one more time, although, admittedly, there was the one match where the netcode just, or the net connection completely tanked, and I'm pretty sure they're on wireless. That's the only thing I can think of why that would happen. They're on wireless, and there was a packet of interference, or just a bunch of interference, not a packet of it. Interference doesn't come in packets. That'd be weird. Be weirdly organized noise. They just all of a sudden the net connection just, oh, come on. Like, the network connection just has packets of interference throughout. That just the ISP just throws. You know, it wouldn't put it past them. Some ISPs, it wouldn't put it past them to just throw in packets of noise. Or packet, like, just take a packet and scramble it somewhere in the way. Okay, so I guess hitting entry... Alright, that worked. I guess hitting entry causes you to be both entered and searching, I guess? Well, I don't know. Clearly they want to play me, so everything that happened before was obviously a game problem. Alright. This is actually why I dislike it. I feel cold now. Like, I really feel like I've cooled off a bit, and that's bad. Because I want to be warm. Like, not, like, cooled off as in not angry. I mean cooled off as in I'm not warmed up anymore. Or I feel less warmed up than I used to. That wasn't... Oh, okay. Good to know, that's invincible. Oops. I'm getting scared of using my pin since Ensenga seems to have invincibility frames against it. Or just invincibility frames in waste of a burst. There we go. Ah. Pop your beach ball. It's a testament to how well the game's graphics work that it... Right, I gotta dash back as I was doing before. It's a testament to how well the game's graphics work as fake 2D that beach ball looks conspicuously CG'd despite the fact that it's just as 3D as everything else in the scene. It's just because it's a spherical object. Oops. Nope. Ah, I thought they were gonna go for a dolphin. Well... Hey, falls defense the whale, finally. Why am I doing that one in the air? That's when I wanted to jump dust. Oh, well, whatever. I guess I clearly have a lot of practice against May's air game. So, we'll end on that. Hooray, I ranked up for losing, or I guess for playing. I guess that must be how it works. Like, you level up for winning, and you rank up for playing. I guess. Like I said, I don't know how it works. My assumption is that there's a provisional rank that it's actually at, and you actually have a deflated ranking. And so what matters is more how quickly you get up there rather than getting up there. Once you get to that provisional rank, it probably works normally. But it's more of a placement system, as you would often find. Anyway, that is going to be it for me tonight. So, oops, I just have to do this. I'm going to go to the main menu for the sake of going to the main menu. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed that. That is going to be it for me tonight. So thanks everyone for watching, and have a good night.